keeping the place orderly and clean. Men, you go to a fancy restaurant and there's a gentleman in there keeping the place in order, right? Most of those guys in the men's room, you know, they're usually like old guys and they're just, you know, kind of hanging out there and, you know, they wipe up and they, you know, there's a little tray with a couple coins in it and you're not really sure why they're there, but they serve a purpose. In this place, standing in a corner, was a 32-year-old man in much better shape than I'm in, which isn't hard to do. He was ramrod straight, flat stomach, had a starched white shirt with a bow tie that was tied perfectly. The crease on his pants was razor sharp, and the shine on his shoes was blinding, standing there in a corner. And I walk in, I say, oh, okay, that's the guy who takes care of the men's room. And he raises his hands, he says, "Welcome to the men's room." So I try to back out of the men's room. I'm not kidding. This is a true story. Hands up in the air. Welcome to the men's room. Hi, how are you? You know, I what do you say? All right. So I walk in and he says, "Stall number 3 is available." I need this kind of stall. He says, "Oh, well, number 2 is available." So I proceed to stall number 2. And now it's time for me to wash my hands. And he says, "Come over here. Come to this sink right here." And he turns the water on and he hands me three napkins. And he says, "So, you're here at Mastro's. Is this your first time?" I said, "Yes, it is." He says, "Are you here to have steaks this evening?" I said, "Absolutely. I understand this is the best place in town." He says, "It's even better than that. You're going to have a wonderful meal. You're going to have a wonderful time. This is going to be a great, great evening for you." Wow. So I look down and there's a tray. There's usually some coins full of dollar bills. Ones, fives, tens, a couple $2 bills in there. And ordinarily, you know, when the guy cleans up after you, you throw a couple coins in there. Well, I felt compelled. I threw a $5 bill in there because the guy's cleaning up after me. He turned the water on. Is the water too hot? No, it's fine. Is it too cold? No, it's fine. Would you like some mints? We have 3 flavors. I'm looking at this guy. He says, "Would you like some cologne?" I said, "No, I'm fine." Okay. I put down my $5 bill. I turn to walk out. He says, "Thank you for coming to the men's room." I run out, I walk to the table, to my buddies. I said, "Guys, you got to go to the men's room. This is the coolest place I've ever been." I proceed to tell them the story. They both went to the men's room. And they came back and said, "Yeah, this little guy's in there saying, welcome to the men's room," to everybody. Okay, this is a true story. I don't remember the steak. I remember the experience. Okay? That's important. I don't remember the steak. This is supposed to be the best steakhouse in town. I'm sure it was wonderful. I'm sure it was wonderful because I don't remember it being bad. But I remember the guy in the men's room. That's on tape. I'm sorry. I remember the experience. That created an experience for me for the rest of the evening. And since I've been there, I've told the story a bunch of times. And I get some laughs. But it's a true story. And the next time I'm in Scottsdale, I can't wait to go back to Mastro's. Why? Not because I had a great steak. I want to see if that little guy's still in the men's room. But it was a great experience for me. Now, I'm sure that I had a great meal. I'm sure that you do a hell of a job providing great landscaping services, Burke. And I'm sure no one's a better air conditioning guy than you are. And I'm sure no one repairs elevators as great as you guys do. But what's the experience that you leave your clients with? What's the experience? Do they remember? Do they remember the steak that you ate? Do they remember the fact that you really are a great landscaper, or that doing business with you is great, or that you serve people, or that you're really in another business? That's the message tonight, folks. What business are you in? If a men's room attendant can make my experience at a restaurant a stellar experience, what can you do for your clients?